Okay, so I'm recording here system diagram of welder versus plasma cutter and how the calculations that you're doing fit in that, and I have the file opened up. Now
Okay.
the file that you sent me, 64 pages of calculations, is that basically screenshots that you kept pasting into a document?
No, I printed the document to the printer as a PostScript file. And then I translated it to PDF format, so that everything printed out.
So you did PS file from the directly from the screen. That's from screenshots.
No, like, it's printing the actual file within Mathcad.
Within Mathcad, you're doing what? Printing the. Print file.
Yeah, this is just a print of the file.
Right. I mean, when you say file, you mean the screenshot of your work window?
It's a Mathcad program, and it's 60 pages of Mathcad, and I just printed that. Single file.
Right, within Mathcad, you're just pretty much printing the screen, the work screen, right? The results screen, the outputs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And in it, I notice you have like also charts. And tables, are those tables also, like, for example, it says Met Glass, input value, summary, output, is that also, that's you copied in that from somewhere else?
That's all part of the Mathcad file.
Okay.
It can do charts and graphs and embedded images.
I see. Okay, so that's good. So, systems diagram of the welder. Going to that, so we'll just go just simply explaining what we have. So we've got...
Just as a note before we get into this, this is only the file for the power factor corrector.
Okay.
There's an equally long file for the phase modulator.
Okay. File, 64 page... Do you have do you have that you can send me?
No. It's not in the good form right now.
Okay.
Next week.
Okay. Okay. Just a side note here, okay. So we start with 240 AC.
Mm-hmm. In the first entry, the first item on the agenda is a power line filter and transient suppressor. If you want to get really specific, in between those two, would be a circuit breaker.
Okay. Let's do that. Circuit breaker within the welder itself?
Yeah. That's the on-off switch. But it needs to be a circuit breaker.
Mm-hmm.
Corrector.
Okay.
And after that, there's a phase modulator, a bridge phase modulator.
Okay.
And that's, then there's an output rectifier.
Okay, output rectifier.
And filter.
Okay.
And that's it.
Okay. Can we add some of these elements, like where does the MCU come in? Can we draw in like, okay, there's the gun, things like that. Gun would be at the end of the output rectifier.
Coming off the circuit breaker.
Mm-hmm.
There's an additional path. Parallel, which is power for the gun control.
Mm-hmm.
And gas control. There's another one in parallel with that, which is gas control.
Okay.
That's it.
So MIG-GUN will be after this power for gun control. So you have a gas cylinder.
A regulator.
Let's put all the little pieces in so we...
After the gas cylinder, there's a regulator. Yeah. There's a power for the gun control. Goes to a motor for the wire drive. A variable speed motor.
And that would go here. Where's the MCU in here? It's under, it connects to... Where does the MCU come in here? It'll be within...
It runs the bridge phase modulator.
Power factor corrector is before the MCU? Or it's not MCU controlled?
No.
It has its own logic chip. It has its own dedicated
CFC chip.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so the power factor corrector. Mm-hmm. Is there any simple way to explain power factor? I mean, I understand the concept that it's like the phase of the voltage and current
They need to be in phase.
Yeah. They need to be in
phase. It's about like a resistor for load.
Yeah.
It turns a capacitor of load into a resistor of load.
I see. That's a simple way to phrase it.
Or otherwise it keeps the voltage and the current in phase.
Yeah. Now, that depends on feedback from the bridge phase modulator.
No, it just looks at what is being demanded of it and keeps the current and the voltage in phase. That's throughout the line cycle. It's applied 390 volts DC to the bridge phase modulator.
Let's see, so we would say
the arrow between the power factor corrector and the bridge phase modulator is 390 volts DC.
Yep.
At about 25 amps.
Who's controlling the gas?
The operator by changing the setting on the regulator. And the neg gun, when the trigger is pulled on the neg gun, a solenoid opens and lets the gas through. So the gas controller is a solenoid.
Is there any case for a variable throughput solenoid control? It can
That's
control.
Not easy.
It's not easy, right?
No.
It's just on and off.
Yeah.
Gas control solenoid, and that goes. There should be an arrow here to from gas control to the MIG gun. Okay, so there's, but that arrow should be two ways, right? Should be like that?
Yep.
And this arrow should be...
Usually have a delay on the turn off of the gas and the... so that there's some gas flowing for a while until the bulb cools.
Until when?
Until the bulb cools down a bit. You want to keep the gas flowing while the bulb is molten. That's all built into the...
So the proper technique is once you depress the welder button, you should keep the gun just a little bit, just a tiny little bit.
Yeah. 20 or 30 seconds.
20 or 30 seconds after you finish the bead?
Yeah. You
20-30 seconds, yeah. That's proper technique. I haven't really. I mean, do a lot of people practice that, or?
That's normal.
That's normal. Like, for example, you know, like at the fab shop, local agricultural fab shop. They, I mean, you finish, you lay the gun off and take it off pretty much immediately.
Yeah, that's common practice, but it's not proper technique.
Uh huh. What's the difference in strength for a weld that's oxidized like that without the 20-30 seconds thereafter?
It's a difference in brittleness.
Is there a number to that?
Nope. I don't have a number.
Mm-hmm. But would that effect be like on a scale of like 10% or... But hold on a second. When I run the Miller-Matic 200, when I depress the gun, the gas does not keep flowing. When I
okay.
So is that bad design?
Yep.
Do the professional or like which welders have the delayed gas?
One example is if you're welding stainless and you let the gas in right away. You turn the gas off right away, the weld would discolor.
Mm-hmm.
If you do it with a steel that's got a lot of additives in it, like a martensite type steel,
mm-hmm.
it'll crack.
So how is this affected when you do stick welding? Because with still stick welding, there is no shielding. So is the flux sufficient to do what you need? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Okay, so delay in gas flowing. I actually never heard of that, actually, till now. Okay. When they do robotic welding, it's common, it's industry standard that they keep the gas flowing for a little more?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Sounds good. So we got the minigun, the bridge phase modulator, the MCU. So the MCU is basically turning the MOSFETs on and off. But it also surely gets some feedback, right?
I can't hear you.
The MCU turns the MOSFETs on and off, but also has feedback.
You're breaking up quite badly.
Is it?
Okay, I can hear you again.
Okay. The MCU turns the MOSFETs on and off, but also has feedback. Right, so what else goes back to the MCU? The MCU has more than that connection there to the bridge phase modulator. It's a 60 wire connection.
Yep.
There's some other connections there. The MCU gets power from its own power, so there's going to be a...
There's a coming out of the circuit breaker. There's an internal power supply. That would be above the power factor corrector, and it supplies both the power factor corrector and the MCU.
Okay. Okay, hold on first. Okay. Internal power supply for the power factor corrector is that lets through all the power, right? It's a power. It's a power element, right? So.
Yes.
So, we draw. Do we draw an arrow from here to MCU? I mean, it's really part. Internal power supply. It's within the MCU.
It goes to the MCU. Yeah.
Well, it's a module that's attached to it.
It's on the. It's a board that plugs into the phase modulator.
It plugs into the modulator with the MCU on that board?
No, it's a separate board from the MCU.
Okay, I'm kind of missing the connections. The power supply feeds the MCU, but it's on a...
Via the 60-pin connector.
Okay.
So maybe you should draw that arrow to the bridge phase modulator.
So the internal power supply is a board that plugs into the bridge phase modulator. The MCU also sits. No, that's. It's going to be a board that plugs in, or how does it sit in there?
It plugs into the phase modulator.
Plugs in, but physically, how are we seeing it? Have you thought about how we would physically attach it?
On standoff, right end of standoff.
Okay. Okay. Now, if that MCU, so that screws. Four screws?
Yeah.
Is it useful to have that more like a, maybe like a slot that's just like a physical slot or something? Or
does it's a right angle to the phase modulator board.
Uh-huh.
So it plugs in edge on.
The MCU?
Yeah. And the internal power supply.
Uh-huh. It plugs in edge on standoffs? Okay. So it's a simple plug-in like a cartridge.
Yes.